Hey everyone, it's Chris from AWeber, and in today's 31 days of landing page design video, I'm going to show you how to make the landing page for the 31 days of landing page design landing page. It should be a fun one, and we'll learn some of the fundamentals of landing page color theory and how to use AWeber's landing page builder to quickly and easily build pages. Let's go. I'm going to be using AWeber to build the landing page today. AWeber is a super easy to use and powerful tool for creators and small businesses. You can create landing pages, email newsletters, even automated email sequences. And each of those things takes just a couple of minutes. So let's jump in. I'm gonna hit this create a landing page button. There are tons of templates that we could choose from, but for the landing page for the 30 days of landing page design, I'm going to start from scratch today just to give you a tour of a bunch of the different tools in the builder. So I'll hit choose. First thing I want to do is change some of my core design settings. So I'm going to change my background color to almost white. So I'm going to go with just a little bit of yellow. So white is FFFFFF in hex, or I could just drag this right up to the corner. But I'm gonna make it a tiny, tiny bit yellow, which I could do by dragging here or by just changing the hex code. So I'll drag that into the yellow family and just move it over ever so slightly. See, you can't even tell in the recording, I'm sure, but it's just a little bit yellow. Now I'm gonna set my background color to almost black. So we're gonna go all the way down into this corner. And then halfway between like blue and purple, I'm just gonna pull it up a little bit. And the reason I do this with both yellow and black is because in nature, like in the real world, you very rarely see like stark white, if ever. You almost never see stark white or true black because there's all sorts of light bouncing around the world coming through windows or through light sources, bouncing off walls and taking the color of the things the light bounces off into the objects around you. So I feel like things that aren't quite true black or true white just feel more natural. Okay, now I'm gonna just clear out some of the placeholder content, start from scratch, boom, boom, boom. And I'm just gonna start with one row. Rows are these, containers that span the whole page, and then inside there just one text element. And here I'm going to start building out my page. The title for my page is 30 days of landing page design. That's the overview, and then underneath it I'm gonna communicate like why bother doing this in the first place. And this will be something like level up your landing page design with 30 days of simple tutorials. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how you can preview this, like the final version of this. You can either preview it just by clicking off. That's actually the easiest way to do it. But if you wanna see what this will look like on a small screen, you can hit preview and then click on the mobile preview. And that'll show you how the page will respond on small screens, which is important because of how often we view websites from our phones. Like I have my phone right in front of me. I can guarantee you that later on tonight, I'll be sitting on my couch, just kind of like browsing the internet. So it's important you make this look good on a phone as well. Last little setup thing is I'm going to call this 30 days of landing page design. Okay, now there are a couple of different sections of content that I want. The first thing is going to be a video. So I'm going to drag in this video placeholder, just drop it right there. Add an extra paragraph's worth of space between my headline and subheading. I actually think I'm gonna take the bolding away from this subheading and maybe make that text a little bit bigger. Yeah. So that is looking better. Nice. Now what I'm gonna add to this video section is a link to the video I'm recording right now. And actually it's gonna be a link to a playlist of all of the videos from this series of 30 days of landing page design. So people can just page through, see all the videos right here in the player. The next section I'm gonna add is gonna be a list of all of the previous videos and placeholders for videos that are coming soon. So I'm going to pull in another text element. It's a really simple page. And I'm going to call this one videos. I'm going to make the style of this an H2. This one up here is an H1, a heading 1. So it's the biggest size text on the page. It's important so people understand the hierarchy of pages or of the page as we go down. Now, videos is heading 2, so it's slightly smaller. You can see this one is 36. This one's 32. And then I'm going to just include a bulleted list for each of the previous, or actually maybe a numbered list for each of the previous videos. As I upload videos to YouTube, I can just copy and paste the link onto this page. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to write coming March 1st, 2022, and I'm going to do that for each of these. So March 2nd, March 3rd, and I'm not going to make you watch me do this, so just give me a sec. Now, the last section I want to add here is, or the last element I want to add is a little form. For people who are interested in this content to join my email list. So I'm going to change this to be a horizontal form so it sits like this. I'm going to, otherwise I think I'll just leave it as it is, but I'm going to make one little change and add a tag. And what this tag means is anyone who signs up from this specific form will have this tag on them in AWeber. So if I want to segment and only send emails to people who signed up from this page, I can easily do that. So I'm going to call this tag will just be 31 days of landing pages. Boom, done. Anyone who signs up will get that tag. So I have to add one more little piece of content here so this form isn't just floating. It's really important that when you're asking someone to sign up for your email list, you explain to them what they can expect to get. When people give you their email, it's generally a transaction where they expect to get something of value in return. In this case, it's going to be updates on other landing page educational resources and tutorials. So my call to action around this here is sign up for my newsletter to get tips and tutorials on building great products. And I'm asking for people's name and email so I can send them personalized emails in the future. And I'm going to change this submit button from submit, which isn't very personalized or interesting, to level me up. Boom. Okay, so we have all the content that I need on this page. But now it's time to spruce it up so it just looks a little nicer. The thing we're going to focus on first is spacing. So there's not enough spacing between some of these elements. The space between my headline and subheading, that's enough, but I need space between my video and the paragraph underneath it. So I'm just going to add an extra space there. And that is probably good. Now, the bigger thing I want to update is this videos section. It takes up, it's too darn wide. So I'm going to pull in a new row and I'm going to turn this into three columns. Boom, boom. Now I'm going to pull this this text element with all these videos into the center column. Okay, now when I preview this, it's starting to look like, it's starting to look a lot better. I'm going to make a couple changes here though. I'm going to call this past videos. I'm going to make this just a little wider on each side. Okay, looking much nicer. Now, this just so we can test and see what the page will look like with an actual video here, I'm going to go grab a video from the AWeber YouTube channel to put in there as a placeholder. So all I have to do is paste the link to that video into this field. AWeber will go out, grab that video and embed it right on the page. So now here I have my headline. Here's the video that's going to be my intro to this 30-day landing page challenge. I have a neat little sign-up section here. and then this list of past videos that I'm going to fill out as I add more videos. I'm going to come back and replace these each with a link. But this will make it clear for folks who are following along what past videos have already been shipped. Okay, a couple changes I want to make. So there's not enough padding around this Powered by AWeber button, so I gotta clean that up. And I just thought of something. For right now, before I start this challenge, which is when I'm making this page, I want a different call to action here. I want people who are interested in getting notified about new videos to sign up, and I'll send them those new videos with an automated campaign. So I'm gonna change that first. And I'm gonna change this to get notified when new videos. So I switched that to sign up to get notified when new videos are live. I'm going to make this an H2 as well because it's going to be a section header. Or maybe I'll make it an H3. Shrink it down just a little bit. Now I'm going to add a little bit more detail underneath it because I'm also going to be sending these people updates issues of my general newsletter. So I wrote, I'll also send you my newsletter full of tips on how to build great products. I'm going to center that as well. Now, while I'm in here, I'm going to add some spacing around this element. This is really helpful to know in general when you're trying to space out your page. If you select a row, you can click on the spacing tab and you can add padding and margin. I'm going to add 20 pixels of padding. Now I'm going to go back to my preview. That looks pretty great. Sign up to get notified when new videos are live. Then the form underneath it. I'm gonna add just actually one line of separation between this line and the form below it, then my videos and the Powered by button. See how it looks on mobile. That reflows pretty darn nicely, except for this past video section. It looks like this needs some padding. So I'm gonna go back to the editor. When I click on this element, you can see that there are 30 pixels of padding on the right and the left, and I'm actually going to switch that to just 20. And I'm going to go down to this row, or this center column, and I'm going to add 20 pixels on the right and the left. I'm going to add that extra line between this section. Now let me preview it again. That looks much, much better. Excellent. And again, in the full desktop preview. And with that, I'm almost ready to launch. Last thing, I want to set a custom URL for my page. So I'm going to go into my page settings. So nothing selected, I click on settings. And I'm going to use my chrisvasquez.design domain. And my page path is going to be 30-days of landing pages. I'm going to save that. Now on my landing page list, I just click on these three dots and hit publish. I'm just going to click on that link. And here is my live landing page ready for me to share.